Thanks for everyone for attending today. As you can see, we've got a webinar today, Lawpath and TikTok. Hopefully a lot of you, I know, are pretty familiar with myself and with Lawpath. If you don't know who I am, I'm Connor Spencer. I'm the team leader of our legal and accounting solutions here at Lawpath. I've been with the business nearly 2 years now. Also as a business consultant. So if anyone does have any questions and more detail on us, if you're new to us, do reach out to me. But we'll talk a bit more at the end about how Lawpath can help, and a bit more on what we do. We're joined today by Ronan Gupta. And if you want to introduce yourself, Ronan, and kind of a bit about what you do with TikTok and everything else.
Brilliant. Thank you, Connor. So, hey everyone, thank you so much for joining us virtually today for this TikTok Ads 101 session, which we'll be co-hosting with Lawpath. My name is Rohan. I support new businesses here at TikTok that are coming onto the platform. That ranges from pretty much any kind of business that is looking to scale on the platform. So that could be drop shippers that are looking to spend a bunch on the platform, all the way up to AustralianSuper, NRMA, those kind of like big enterprise businesses as well. So I deal with all of them when they first come onto TikTok, and I help kind of scale them up if they are looking to scale. Now, before we start, if you do have any questions during the webinar, please send them through. I'll try to answer as many as I can as possible. And we'll also try and leave some time at the end for some Q&As. But without further ado, let's get into today's session. So first, we're going to be covering off TikTok current state, including some demographic insights. We'll then take a look at the TikTok ads products and their use cases. Next, we'll cover some of our creative best practices and creative tools that you can leverage. And finally, we'll answer the age-old question on how big does your budget need to be for ads? So let's get started. So TikTok's current state. TikTok's the fastest growing social platform in the world right now. And we've grown at an unprecedented level. So we've hit 1 billion global users quicker than any other platform in history, as you can see from the graph here. Now, in Australia alone, we've got 10.7 million active monthly users who, on average, open the TikTok app 20 times a day, and they create 21.9 million videos every month. By the way, just before I go on, you will get this deck after the presentation, so don't feel the need to take down like every single note on these slides. Now, when it comes to average time spent on TikTok, users are spending a movie's length of time on TikTok every day, considerably more than any other platform, with our closest competitor being YouTube. If we look at just the 18 to 35-year-old population in Australia, 95% of them are on TikTok. So that works out to be virtually half of all adults in Australia on the platform. And when we break down our user base by generation, just over 40% of users are between the ages of 18 to 24, which is Gen Z. No prizes for guessing that our audience skews younger, but you might find it surprising as well that that leaves around 60% of the age of 20 over the age of 25, and over a quarter of TikTok users who are above 35. In fact, the average age on TikTok in Australia is 32. Now, TikTok gives you access to an audience that isn't found on other platforms. For example, 34% of TikTok users aren't on Instagram, and 48% of TikTok users aren't on Facebook. Now, this is one of the biggest reasons why businesses are looking to TikTok as a new platform to introduce into their media mix. So we know that we've got 10.7 million users in Australia on TikTok, but how many businesses are leveraging our incredibly engaged audience? So it's 350,000 businesses right now, and it's constantly growing. These businesses use our platform to grow their brands and then connect with new customers as well. So why are 350,000 businesses turning to TikTok? Well, it's because our TikTok users are coming to our platform to discover new products and services on TikTok. In fact, at least once a month, more than 3 million Australians visit a restaurant or purchase a product or service they've discovered on TikTok. So let's dive into some of the ad solutions that you can leverage and that your businesses can leverage to be discovered on TikTok. Just trying to see if there's any questions yet. Hopefully, Jessica, you can see the video now. Okay, so let's start with how TikTok ads show up on TikTok. 98% of time on TikTok is spent in the For You feed, or the FYF, as we call it. This is the place where users serve videos based on what the recommendation system deems to be of interest to that user. And it's in this For You feed where your ads will show up. As you can see here, ads are broken up by several organic TikTok videos, with there being 7 videos on average between ads. Now, the reason these ads are surrounded by regular in-feed organic videos is so as not to disrupt the scrolling experience of the user. We ideally want them to not even realize that you're making an ad. So when you're creating content and creating videos, try and make it feel as native as possible, as opposed to those conventional TV and YouTube ads, which just scream your business name and your logo. Now, you can set up various ad objectives on TikTok Ads Manager. Another way to think about these ad objectives on the right-hand side of the screen are the campaign types. For example, if you're looking to get as many eyes on your brand and increase brand recognition, then a reach campaign will likely serve you best, or a focus views campaign, which will optimize for people to watch your videos for at least 6 seconds. Now, if you want to drive people to click on your ad, go to your website, a traffic campaign may be best. And if you want to drive conversions on your website, then a conversion campaign may be best suited, as it optimizes towards people who are more likely to buy after seeing a TikTok ad, instead of just visiting your website but not carrying out any action. So as you can see, TikTok ads allow you to achieve full funnel marketing. And these kind of objectives and these campaign structures are very similar to Meta. So if you've had experience with Meta ads, you should be pretty familiar with these sort of objectives. And these objectives can be stacked for a nurtured account strategy. Take HiSmile, for example, the teeth whitening company. I'm sure a lot of you have seen their ads before, but they simply run a focus views campaign where they're making sure people watch their videos and are educated about their product continuously. They then run a conversion campaign over the top to target those customers most likely to buy their product, with promotions and clear talk call to actions to buy now. So by having these two campaign types running side by side and always on at the same time, they've constantly got a new pool of users who are being nurtured and educated about their product, so that when the signals indicate these users may be ready to buy, they can convert them into customers with a conversion campaign. So, when you post an ad, do you need an organic TikTok account, or can you post ads without linking it to any sort of TikTok account? Well, the good news is that either work. So we've got these two types of ads. We've got Spark ads and diversion ads. Spark ads are ads which are connected to your business's organic TikTok account. So that's the organic TikTok account on your phone. Now, from a branding perspective, we see significant reductions in CPMs, or cost per mil, and increased brand recall when businesses use Spark ads. So this is really good for like top of funnel branding stuff. However, it does take time and consistent posting to build a strong organic profile, and it's not always practical. So diversion ads are our dark ads, which don't require an organic account to be linked to them. Now, you can upload your company logo to the ad and it will look like an ad linking to an organic account. The primary difference is that anywhere a user clicks or swipes on a diversion ad, it will take them to your designated landing page or URL. On a Spark ad, as you can see on the left, only the call to action button, which is the red button down the bottom, will take you to the landing page. So an example of a business that uses diversion ads for conversions is Crocs. Even though they've got a really strong organic presence with millions of followers, they choose to post diversion ads so that when a user swipes or click on the ad, they get taken to their website every single time so that they're generating more sales. So Spark ads and diversion ads are both at your disposal, and both formats have their benefits. But what's the campaign type that's actually going to get you conversions? Well, I'm going to be taking you through our lead generation and product sale campaigns today as two options to generate conversions for your businesses. Now, I know the majority of the people on this call today are from kind of businesses in the professional services industry, which is why I'm going to talk about lead generation. It does also help retail businesses, but then I'll also talk about a retail business product that helps with conversions as well. So first up, lead generation ads. We've got two different types of lead gen solutions to help you connect and nurture your leads. And these solutions can be used together to help strike a balance between quantity and quality. Now, we know that audiences are flocking to TikTok to buy a home, to find out what college to go to apply for a loan, which means that the next generation of lead generation is on TikTok. In fact, 1 in 5 TikTok users have submitted forms related to professional services on TikTok. So what exactly are these solutions? Well, Instant Forms are our mobile-first lead gen solution, which prompts users to fill out a form in-app. The forms have ultra fast load times and reduce your cost per lead as there's less friction to the form. So when they see an ad, they're going to click on the call to action button and it's just going to instantly appear with that lead gen form. It feels native to the platform. It doesn't feel like you're going external off the site. And these sort of lead gen forms produce a higher quantity of leads. The best part about instant forms as well is that we have a seamless no-code integration with CRMs and CDPs such as Salesforce, HubSpot, and Klaviyo, which means that even though your lead data may be captured within TikTok, it's going to flow in real time to the tools your sales and marketing teams are using. Now, I know this ad solution speaks to mostly professional services businesses, but for any retailers on the call, this solution can also work for you. I work with several retailers who use instant forms to update and add new potential customers to their EDMs to retarget during seasonal moments. For example, about 8 weeks out from the end of financial year sales, we ran an instant form lead generation campaign for these retailers. And the creative kind of talked about, you know, we're going to be running these end of financial year sales. We will send you a discount code if you sign up. If you want that discount code, sign up, fill out your email, fill out your phone number, and we will send that to you when it drops. What that meant was they had this whole new audience to target with the EDMs. They also had a really warm, engaged audience to retarget with their TikTok ads. So they started sending out creatives to this audience pool and nurturing them. And when the end of financial year sales hit, there was an ad that said, check your inbox, you've got a discount code. There was another ad that said, sale is live, go check it out now. And then also the products that these people had been looking at, these products were on the ad so they could click on it and go to cart straight away. So that's a way in which retailers can also leverage these lead generation instant forms. Next, we've got our website lead generation tool, which allows businesses to leverage the optimization of a lead generation campaign, but it still drives users to their existing lead gen or inquiry forms on their website. So this option is perfect for clients who may have a more complex qualifying process. For example, law firms might be a great example for this, where you might need a little bit more information, you might need some identification, that sort of thing. But I want to take a quick look at Driver, which is a motor vehicle financing firm who achieved really great results on TikTok by leveraging these lead generation ads. So Driver used this solution to direct people to their website for a debt consolidation loan pre-check, which their primary goal was to drive more page views, contact actions, and then form submissions. So this campaign setup allowed Driver to unlock new audiences and accelerated conversions with the results speaking for themselves. A 16% increase in conversion rate, a 19% decrease in cost per lead thanks to custom audience exclusions. What we mean by custom audience exclusions is they didn't want to target anyone who had already signed up in like the last 30 days, that sort of stuff. So you're not wasting money on existing customers. And then over 720,000 impressions. Now, Driver exclusively uses lead generation campaigns and have adopted an always-on strategy throughout the year, which has helped them to enhance lead quality and then drive a strong ROAS on TikTok. Now, for retailers and e-commerce businesses online today, I thought I'd quickly cover off our product sales solution that will hopefully be helpful for you this holiday season. Now, product sales is the perfect campaign objective if you're looking for conversions and have a catalog. If you don't have a catalog, just use the regular conversions campaign. But if you do have a catalog, all our data indicates that a catalog sales campaign will outperform a regular conversion campaign. So catalog sales, or video shopping ads, as they're also known, are ads where your product catalog will appear in the bottom left of the screen as your video showcases the product. Now, these shopping ads are the perfect way and the perfect always-on solution to speed up the process from product browsing to buying. We've got integrations with platforms like WooCommerce, like Shopify, so it's super simple to import your catalog into TikTok Ads Manager as well. And as you can see on screen, these ads reduce cost per acquisition by 13% compared to non-video shopping ads, and also increase ROAS by 32% on average when compared to non-video shopping ad campaigns. So what does a proper nurtured strategy look like? I'm going to walk you through an example of a nurtured account strategy and use some creative examples from mobile storage company Taxibox and also a Dior creative for our retailers out there. Ideally, we want to start with a top of funnel campaign type, such as a reach campaign or a video views campaign as seen on screen. Here, focus on having a really strong hook and explicit brand identity in these videos. TaxiBox's creatives here start off with the hook, free up space and declutter your home with TaxiBox, while showcasing off the yellow truck and the logo multiple times throughout the video. Now, this is the perfect branding video and is educating the audience on this service that they provide. Now, after running a video views campaign for ideally 2 to 4 weeks and building up those signals within the ad account, we hopefully will know, or TikTok will hopefully know, who your target audience is, or at least who are the people that are most likely to engage with your content. After 2 to 4 weeks, you can move down the funnel to a traffic campaign to drive users to your website and begin building signals from your website and pixel data. Now, showcasing everyday scenarios with real people and demonstrating the service is super beneficial here. In this creative, TaxiBox have leveraged a creator to show TikTok users how easy the experience of moving houses with TaxiBox and exactly what you can expect if you were to book their services. It generates interest and undoubtedly get people clicking on the ad and checking out the website. And finally, they leveraged a lead generation campaign using another creator who talks about TaxiBox's 25% off promotion that they're currently running. In this video, there's a clear call to action. She talks to the details of this promotion and encourages users to take full advantage of this promotion whilst they've got the chance. It's a perfect lead gen creative. I've also included an example by Dior of a really great conversion creative. They leverage a creator to do a product try on and give this product a customer perspective rather than a brand perspective. Those brand perspectives are really great for the top of funnel kind of stuff. But when it comes time to buying, TikTok users trust other creators or other users who have used the products before, not the brands themselves. So product try-ons or product demonstrations demonstrate an 89% uplift in purchases or purchase intent. And I'll speak to the product demo a little bit later. It is one of our creative best practices. So I know this was a lot of information on ads, but hopefully you understand the importance of a nurtured account strategy and which products may work best for your business. Now, before we move on to kind of the creative part of this presentation and a little bit more fun, I might just pause for a few seconds and see if there were any questions or burning questions on the content that I've already presented on.
I've got, a question, Rohan, and I might be skipping ahead a bit for you, but in terms of, guys, what you provide with businesses, is there a lot of help with like creating these videos? Like I myself would probably struggle to put a video together. Do you guys offer that?
Yeah, so we don't specifically make videos for advertisers, but I'm going to go through some creative tools which are going to help with creating content. We also do have kind of, I'm going to go through the creative marketplaces, which is where you can find creators to help leverage and they can make videos for you. That's probably one of the easiest and best ways because they already know how to create good TikTok videos. And those are sort of the videos that are going to perform the best. So definitely, we don't actually create the videos ourselves, but we've got creators who you can get in touch with who will create videos for you. And I'll also go through some creative tools which are going to help. I'm just reading here in the chat. I've made a reel in studio that now feels a bit forced. It's a more traditional company intro. I'm guessing, Jessica, you're talking about the creative studio and maybe using some AI. I'm not too sure. I'm going to go through, I don't know if you're talking about the studio, maybe the creative center. Okay, gotcha. It was you talking. Feels a bit more forced. Yeah, absolutely. I'm going to show an example of a founder story a bit later on. There are certain ways to do it. And I know that speaking to the camera, I'm guessing, Jessica, you're speaking to the camera. The camera's up here and you're just speaking directly to it. That is super, super scary. And it's super difficult. And the people who can do it, good for them. They're amazing and they do it really well. But most people can't do that. And I can't do that either on TikTok. If I was to make videos, the best way around that is to create your footage. If it's an informative video about the kind of the service you're providing, I think it was a law firm, talk about what you guys do through a voiceover. So you can film some stuff, maybe make it educational, but then do the voiceover over the top of that. Mm-hmm. Voiceovers are an awesome way to make TikTok videos. And they don't necessarily are outperformed by speaking directly to the camera. You can do both really effectively. So if the speaking to the camera feels unnatural, Definitely use the voiceover feature. And if you don't like the sound of your voice, and you don't want to use that, we've got the AI robots, which can do it for you. You just give them the script. That is native to TikTok now. So the users are very comfortable with the AI bots, and they're not going to just skip past your video because you use them, because everyone uses them. I'm into cybersecurity business. How can I leverage on TikTok for my business? Awesome. So I think with cybersecurity, Haviz, you might be selling to other businesses, perhaps. If you are, we've got a lot of B2B businesses coming on to TikTok. I think there's a misconception that like key decision makers aren't necessarily on TikTok. Yeah, perfect. Key decision makers aren't necessarily on TikTok. One in three key decision makers currently in Australia, and that keeps growing, are on TikTok every single day. So we've got the key decision makers there, and even like the big B2B companies like Salesforce, HubSpot, all those kind of companies, they're advertising on TikTok as well, because they know that, you know, these CEOs and founders of these businesses are still on TikTok. They're still spending time there. 60% of our audience is above the age of 24. So you're going to have a crossover there. And doing some educational pieces on exactly, I guess, why cybersecurity is important, what your service is, what it provides, because there's also a lot of different cybersecurity platforms out there. You can speak to maybe the challenges that are typically in the industry. I don't know not much about cybersecurity. I know Darktrace has a big presence here. But maybe you could speak to like the benefits of coming to a small to medium biz SMB company for your cybersecurity needs, whether that's like kind of the speed for implementation, whether that's more of like a personalized touch, whether that's cost. Speaking to those challenges would be great. How many qualifying questions can you ask on the TikTok form? Alex, I believe it's 10 currently. That might be increasing as well, but I think currently it's 10. You can also integrate it with your online form and like make it more rich with data. So it can have your logo, it can have like things flashing up and about. So it doesn't necessarily just have to be like the most basic, simple form. It can also be like rich content forms. And then how do you set up a TikTok business account and what is the cost? So Dinah, a TikTok business account, when we're talking about a TikTok business account, we're talking about the TikTok account on your phone. You actually just download the TikTok app, create a business account, and then it will create a personal account initially. On the bottom right-hand side of the TikTok account, if you press on those three bars, click on that, it will then say switch to business account. It's completely free. There's no cost. A TikTok ad account is done online on your computer. If you just look up TikTok ads or TikTok ads manager, that's also free to set up. So none of these things to set up have any cost. Might I answer the last question from Sarah and then keep going? Do you have a business account to use these, or can it be a creator? Sarah, could you clarify to use which benefit, sorry, or which tools? Yeah, I might keep going for now, but pretty much there's no limitation, Sarah. So you can have a creator account or you could have a business account. You'll still be able to like kind of integrate it with your TikTok ads manager account. Okay, I'm going to move on to the creative aspect of things. Okay, so creative. Now, I wanted to start this section with this TikTok stat. So 75% of your campaign impact on TikTok is driven by creative metrics, which means that no matter how well your campaign is set up, or even how sophisticated your targeting strategy is, if your creators aren't engaging, your ads aren't going to see success. So we can give you the best kind of campaign setup, but if you're not investing in your creatives and kind of working towards making those creatives as engaging as possible and native to TikTok, ads aren't going to be working for you or aren't going to work for you. Now, the reason why so many SMBs are discovered and their content is seen by millions every day on TikTok is because our recommendation system differs from the conventional social graph. So platforms like Meta, Twitter, LinkedIn are all built on a social graph, meaning that content from friends, family, and the people you follow are prioritized. So on Meta, the bigger your brand or the bigger your following, the greater your potential reach. TikTok's completely different. So we're built on a content graph, which means that we prioritize content that's engaging over just prioritizing content posted to the platform by accounts in a user's network. And this is why small to medium businesses can compete with the big players like Nike, L'Oreal, Apple, because we won't prioritize their content over yours just because they've got a bigger following. That's why we saw Frank Green a few years ago. They made some really engaging content about their water bottles and their car hack, and like using the Bunnings warehouse hack to put their water bottles in cars. They blew up from there, and they leveraged that to then generate ads and generate sales and grow their business. So we're built on a content graph, and it means that anyone can be discovered. Now I'm going to take you through our creative codes here at TikTok, and there's going to be some videos after this of some examples, but think of these as the secret sauce that helps your videos work harder, giving them their best chance at finding new audiences. Our head of creative at TikTok Australia actually developed these over the last 3 years in collaboration with our marketing science team. And these are now the creative codes which are leveraged by TikTok's creative teams across the world. So let's get started with our first one. So first frame hook. What we mean by this is starting off strong in your videos. Only 2.5 seconds of TikTok exposure is sufficient to capture 50% of awareness and ad recall impact on users, which means the first 2.5 seconds are key. So integrate your brand, key message, or hook as early as possible. All you need to do is give people a reason to watch your TikTok video. Let's take a look at this video by Pizza Hut New South Wales. Let me know if you guys can hear the audio.
I can't hear the audio on it, Ryan.
People are lining up for our new double-decker pizza. Your favorite. Okay.
Yeah, it's working now.
Oh, it is?
Yeah, it just started.
As you can see, people are lining up for our new double-decker pizza. Your favorite classics are now decked out to the max with cheese on top and gooey, stretchy, melting cheese below. Grab yours today at your local Pizza Hut, because the Hut's got you covered.
That was brilliant.
So clearly they've leveraged a visual surprise hook at the start of their video to try and keep people watching, and it did just that. That video had an average user stay time of 13 seconds of the total 19 seconds and received 9.6 million views. All from, have a long that video, 20 second video. So having a really great first frame hook, drawing people in, that's going to keep people staying on for longer, and the longer people stay on, the more we push out those videos. Next up, we've got attention triggers. Now that's just a fancy way of saying editing techniques to keep people watching and making it engaging. So think movement, scene changes, text overlay, voiceovers, music, whatever it takes to keep the energy up. There are so many editing techniques you can use, but remember, a high number of attention triggers are likely leading to increased ad recall. Let me show you a founder story which incorporates these attention triggers really well and tells the founder story really exceptionally.
Hi, I'm Sarah, and you may know me as the Ice Facial Girl, or the girl that invented the contour cube. And that's all thanks to my mom. She used ice cubes with her hands, but it was cold, slippery, and messy, so it gave me an idea. So I put two and two together and created the contour cube, making facial icing easy. And she loves it. So now I make it for everyone, and that's all thanks to this one. Thanks, Mom.
That's got text overlay, voiceover, music, scene changes. That video got 7.6 million views.
Hi.
Next, we've got native creative. Now, this is a term that gets thrown a lot here at TikTok. Native creatives are videos on TikTok that are sympathetic to the media environment. That is the For You page or the For You feed. Now, these are videos that don't disrupt a user's scrolling experience, but rather blend between the organic videos that are shown before and after your ad. So creating this style of content can be done simply by filming with a smartphone, leveraging trends in a fun and creative way, or by featuring creators, employees, and even your own customers. Now let's watch this example by Bailey Nelson, who leveraged one of their creators.
Right, make sure you get ones that, you know, cover your eyes.
What?
They need to actually cover your eyes. I don't want a minuscule triangle shape. Here.
Okay, Dad.
The circumference needs to be generous.
Okay, Dad.
Protect your retinas.
Okay. Ooh. I like these.
Yeah, that's quite a rich color. Give them here.
Right.
So to me, this that video obviously goes for a little longer. I just wanted to cut it a bit short. To me, this doesn't look like an ad at all. By using a TikTok creator who took the audience through an entertaining narrative, as well as leveraging features such as on-screen text and the green screen effect, Bailey Nelson were able to capture attention without disrupting the organic For You feed scrolling experience.
Right, make sure you get...
Next up, we've got the product demo, which we were talking about a little bit before. Yes, the Humble product demo even works on TikTok, and it works really well. Now, demonstration videos are a great way to prove the claims that you've made about your product or service by showing it in action. For businesses that might not be able to kind of show a lawn mowing service, we're talking educational stuff here. So educating the audience or talking to your customer stories on people that you've helped before. Now, they make it easy for your customers to imagine elevating their routine, their home, or their lifestyle with your brand. Now, let's watch this example by Tim, the lawnmower man.
You know how I told you I'm not going to ask you for anything to mow the lawn? I'm going to ask you for one thing. I need to know where the water meter is. I don't want to run over it. Ah, beautiful. I was mowing one down there last week, and the lady, she ran over her water meter. There was water going everywhere.
Things first, I'm just going to uncover the water meter so I don't destroy it.
So a place to share and enjoy lawn mowing videos like that has never existed before. There was certainly never a place for businesses to capitalize on this. That video got more than 7 million views, and Tim's completely booked out now and is trying to hire new people to join his business.
You know how.
Now, let's assume you've followed all the previous creative codes and have managed to hook and engage your TikTok audience. Your final step is to ensure these users take action before scrolling onto the next video. Now, people can complicate call to actions, but I see call to actions on TikTok as super simple. If you want users to do something, tell them what you want them to do. Now, a call to action on TikTok should be clear, should be direct, should be concise. Let's look at an example by Eubank. If any of you are on TikTok, I'm sure you're seeing these ads pop up again. They're kind of quintessential TikTok for Australia.
When people ask us for money, we only have one thing to say. $20. $20. $20.
That video doesn't require that much effort. I'm sure they pulled that together in less than a day. But with such a clear, direct, and concise call to action, and after nurturing their customers through video view campaigns and traffic campaigns and building that brand awareness, this creative helped contribute to a 304% increase in app installs. Now, our final code is trends. Trends are a big thing on TikTok. They're basically reputable storytelling formats or structures that you can use to insert your business's story. So think of them as genres on TikTok that are sticky ideas, which you can adapt and then make your own because people know exactly what to expect when you use them. Now, just because trends are typically leveraged by individual users on TikTok, it doesn't mean that businesses can't use them too to take advantage of the hype surrounding them. Now, I'm going to take you through how the looking for a man in finance trend came alive on TikTok earlier this year. Hopefully, some of you have heard of it before.
I'm looking for.
Okay, so this trend started with a creator called Girl on Couch posting a video asking whether she had written the song of the summer, and she invited DJs across TikTok to remix the sound. Now, I'm going to play that video for you here.
I'm looking for a man in finance, the trust fund, 6'5", blue eyes, finance. Trust fund, 6'5", blue eyes. I'm looking for a man. I'm looking for a man. I'm looking for a, looking for a, looking for a, looking for a, finance, trust fund.
We get the gist, but she's come up with that jingle, and then she's at the end of that video invited DJs, and the caption invited DJs to remix it. A girl who was studying a music major at NYU then saw that video and then created this remix of those lyrics.
I'm looking for a man in finance, trust fund, 6'5", blue eyes. Finance, trust fund, 6'5", blue eyes. Finance, trust fund, 6'5", blue.
And that song, I'm sure a lot of you have heard across TikTok, Instagram. It was pretty much everywhere. After this remix, this song blew up on TikTok, and the creators around the world were obsessed with the song, and so many people were using it. And then Duolingo jumped on the trend and made it their own with this creative.
I'm looking for a man in finance, trust fund, 6'5", blue eyes. Finance, trust fund, 6'5", blue eyes, finance, trust fund.
That got 10.5 million views. And even though this video wasn't necessarily trying to drive conversions, with such a viral video, it improved brand image and almost certainly led to increased conversions, all from a 13-second video. And then homegrown Australian fashion retailer Industry made their trend, made this trend their own too. Let me play this creative for you.
I'm looking for a man in finance, the trust fund, 6'5", blue eyes, finance, trust fund, 6'5", blue eyes, finance, the trust fund, 6'5", blue eyes, finance, trust fund, 6'5".
That video got 12.8 million views. So the key takeaway is use trends when relevant and make them your own, because if you can get them right, your businesses could quite literally explode overnight like countless other SMBs across the world. Now, the one thing I will caution with trends is that trends rise and die really quickly on TikTok. And sometimes they eventually come back, but in the initial stages, they will climb and they will die very quickly. This video that Industry did was then that idea, that concept was copied by the glue store about 4 weeks later. Instead of giving out croissants to finance bros in the city, they gave out Stanley cups. But because everyone was over the trend and everyone had already seen the Industry video, all the comments on that video were just hate comments about how they've copied Industry, come up with some original thoughts. And even the girl in this Industry video commented on their post saying, really original marketing girlies. So the whole, like the glue stores video didn't go viral at all. It got negative comments. It got negative reaction. So just making sure that if you are going to leverage trends, trying to jump on it as quickly as possible and kind of recognizing when it might be dying, super crucial.
Is there ever an example of where the reverse is true? Has something ever come back and been popular again? That doesn't include fashion.
Fashion for sure. There are so many videos every day being created about, like, you know, jorts came back, I guess, earlier this year, last year. They came back and then all the businesses were going on it. It's hard to think of on the spot trends that have come back. But there will be products that get released and they have a really, like, they fail at the release and they come back later and they become huge. For example, there's someone on TikTok called Logan who makes cucumber salad videos, and his videos are blowing up right now. And in order to make these cucumber salad videos, he needs to slice the cucumbers, but he can't be bothered to chop them up. So he uses a cucumber slicer, a specific one. And that product launched years ago, and this company that made them had never really sold them out. They were just a product, I guess, on the shelves. Because of Logan's videos, those products are now sold out across the world, and you can't buy that specific cucumber slicer anymore. So these creators have the power to create a trend and then, like, completely sell out or book out all your business.
Mommy.
I'm looking for a man in.
Ooh, it's going to be stuck in your head all day. Okay, so we've spoken about how important creatives are, but I want to quickly take you through some creative resources, which I highly recommend you check out in your own time. So first up, we've got the TikTok Creative Center. Now, this is where you can see the top performing hashtags, the songs, creators, and ads across TikTok globally and in Australia. If you're struggling for creative examples for your ads, make your way to the top performing ads and you can search for keywords or even competitors in the search bar to see if they have posted recent ads on TikTok. I use this all the time. For example, if you're a law firm, go to the hashtags, look up legal or legal advice or law firms or legal help, and you will see how the trend's going right now from a views point of view on that hashtag in Australia over the last 12 months. You'll be able to see whether, you know, legal inquiries are rising on TikTok right now or whether they're kind of plateauing and stuff. So there's some really great insights there. Next up is our chatbot on the Creative Center called Symphony Assistant. So think of this as our version of ChatGPT. You can ask it anything and it will provide answers based on our internal data. For example, you can ask it for creative ideas for your business, script ideas for these videos, and competitive videos that have done well within your industry. Try it out. It's an awesome tool. It's not leveraged enough by enough businesses, and most businesses don't even know about it, but we internally use it all the time. And it comes up with some really great ideas based on previous videos doing well. Then I spoke about this briefly, but TikTok's Creator Marketplace is our platform for businesses to contact creators, see insights into these creators' accounts, such as their audience breakdown and also their starting prices. You'll also need to fill out your ABN details before you get access to this platform, but definitely try it out, as creators are a great way to resonate with your audience. And lastly, CapCut. I constantly hear people say that they've heard rumors that content edited within TikTok is prioritized over content edited within CapCut. I'm here to say that's unequivocally not true. CapCut's actually owned by us and it's one of our editing platforms. And we encourage businesses to use CapCut when editing content. It's a better app than the in-app TikTok editing software. So please ignore those rumors and go test out CapCut. So for those of you still with me right now, we're onto the final part of the presentation, pricing, the age-old question, how much do I need to spend on TikTok ads? Well, the answer is completely dependent on your goal. So as you can see here, we have an equation that we use to recommend budgets and a few inputs that we can play around with. The most important input will be your desired cost per action or your desired CPA. Now, this metric is going to change based on the type of campaign you run. So if you run a reach campaign, it may be your desired CPMs or cost per mil, so cost per 1,000 impressions. If it's a traffic campaign, it might be desired cost per click, or if it's a conversion campaign, it might be the cost per complete payment. After you've put in your desired CPA, you need to input your desired weekly conversions. Now, conversion in this doesn't always mean a complete payment. It actually refers to the event you described in your CPA. For example, if you're running a reach campaign and your desired CPM is $5, your desired weekly conversions would refer to the number of impressions you're looking to run, looking to get each week. If it was a traffic campaign and you're measuring cost per click, conversions would refer to the number of clicks on your ads you want per week. The optimization multiplier is to give businesses a buffer. However, feel free to take this component out initially if budgets are a little bit tighter. And then the rest of the equation is the number of weeks you want to run the campaign for and the number of ad groups within your campaign. And that is how you get a recommended budget for TikTok ads. You'll get this deck afterwards, so you'll have this equation, and based on what your goals are, you can put those metrics into there. Really great for agencies as well if they're recommending budgets. Now, we have a limited time offer here where if you sign up to TikTok Ads Manager using the link that will be sent to all of your emails after this webinar, you'll be eligible for some credit reimbursement to help test out TikTok. We've also got a webinar exclusive offer for businesses on this webinar. So if you've got an initial budget of $5,000 to spend across 2 consecutive months, you'll be eligible to receive one-on-one support from a TikTok ads expert. If you don't have time to scan this QR code now, don't worry, we'll send it across to you in a follow-up email. But that's all from me today. And I think I'm just going to pass over to Connor now from LawPath to take you through some legal considerations.
Awesome. Thanks, Ronan. I feel a bit snubbed, actually, because that was all really interesting. And now I get to present probably the most boring aspect, or at least fun aspect of it. But really, really important, guys. Just hang on the slide for a moment, Ronan, because we're just going to quickly showcase a few legal documents. But there are a few other considerations when you are, you know, marketing and advertising your businesses as well. First and foremost is actually complying with the Spam Act. There's important requirements around, you know, if you're sending something out, you must be identifiable to the recipient. So it might be including your name, your ABN, ACN, contact details, potentially in their email message. Every email must have an unsubscribe link or a reply email to which the unsubscribe request can be sent. And if you're associated with anyone else, you might also need to include like government bodies, political parties, charities, and even religious organizations in there as well. And that's largely just all in relation to the Spam Act of 2003. You also need to consider other things around the Australian consumer law. And those important considerations are just largely around misleading and deceptive conduct, false representations, testimonials you may use on your social media or website, unconscionable conduct and unfair terms. So just like I said, as interesting as it gets. We can just go to the next slide now, Ronan. So as a bare minimum, though, you do need obviously some legal documents for your websites. You know, they are very much the foundation, the backbone of your business. So what you need to have when running an online store, you have the same obligations as physical store would have. There's no real differentiation there. So there's a number of legal documents you'll need to run your business and obviously make sure your website is compliant. So go to the next one, Ronan. I believe it's the privacy policy.
Yeah. Kind of just jumping in here as well. If you're a any kind of like business and you do have legal documents that you need to abide by, we also require you to upload those into the TikTok ads manager before you can run ads. So if you're a financial services company, you'll need to upload your AFSL. If you're in the therapeutic goods business, you'll need to upload your ARTG certificate. If you're a legal firm, you'll need to upload the relevant requirements or legal requirement document as well.
Yeah, awesome. That's great to know. So first and foremost is that privacy policy. So what actually is that? It informs your user what you'll do with their personal information. Australia really, really stringent on data protection and privacy. It's really, really important here. They actually are looking to update some legislation end of this year. And they actually made some changes back in 2022. You guys might remember two kind of infamous data breaches back in 2022, both with Optus and Medibank. So Optus had a breach. Back then, they can get breaches up to 2.2 million. These days, now after some amendments in December 2022, I believe it was, you can now get serious breaches up to a $50 million fine with Medibank to actually seal the breach and then to address a certain number of issues in like customer support packages. Actually cost them around $35 million. Obviously, these are examples of big companies, but even for small businesses, if you're found not compliant, if you're found to, at a minimum, not having that privacy policy on your website, you can actually cop up to an 11 grand fine. So really important it's you're using this document, regardless of the size of your business. And obviously, why you need, obviously, your privacy policy will inform your customer how you'll use their information or who you'll be sharing it with. It all includes anything from names, emails, addresses, their credit card information, their address, anything personal to that person, and you need to document how you'll store and save that information. And just go to the next one, please. All right, cheers. So yeah, and then the website terms and conditions of use on LawPath, we have many variations of this document. So we have like a website terms of use for goods, for services, and examples for like very specific types of businesses as well. But the website terms of use is communicate to anyone using your website, the terms and conditions of interacting with your website. So these need to be really specific, like our templates, you know, they have all the meat and bones, but they're pretty broad as well to be able to fit many different businesses who need them. So definitely get some advice or really make sure if you're filling out yourself that you're adding in as much information as you can. You guys probably see sometimes where, you know, might be on CommBank and they're updating their terms of use or their privacy policy. It's normally because if any business is doing that, there's either been changes in legislation or a loophole has probably been exposed or something's gone wrong and they're just basically filling that in. So some of the key clauses in there needs to include is protection of your intellectual property, disclaimers, limitations of liability, and it's cut off there, but things that are prohibited when actually using the website. And just go to my final slide. So sales, terms and conditions. So again, we have different variations of these. Some of the key clauses we tend to have is obviously describing in quite specific detail the products you sell and how you sell them, payment procedures, availability of those products, delivery of products, your consumer guarantee, your refund, return and exchange policy, and obviously your limitation of liability. Those two final ones are really, really key as well and often catch people out. So make sure you're getting advice on those when you're writing them in. So if you do intend to sell some products online or even if it's a service you're offering, you should have a terms and conditions surrounding the sale. People will often actually get an invoice as well to finalize any purchase. All products and services obviously come with customer guarantee if they are for personal domestic use or cost less than 100,000. But that's it from those sort of bare minimum slides. There are often other documents as well we recommend to clients who just need to understand a bit more about your business and what you're trying to achieve. I think most people in this call are actually pretty familiar with LawPath and how we can help. But if we just go to the next slide, Ronan, We are promoting, just go to the next one. 20% off on our legal advice plan to attendees today. It's on our quarterly subscription. Typically, we bill just $537 every 3 months for unlimited consultations, all of our documents, and unlimited on-call contract reviews. If you do want to join on with that, you can get it as low as $427 with that 20% discount. Really invaluable. A lot of the documents, including the three that I mentioned there, if you were to go to a lawyer to have those drafted, even at a pretty basic level, you're looking at about 2 to 3 grand to have those documents for your site. You can grab those and access to our lawyers for just $427 per quarter. Cool. And there's a bit more description there. Just a reminder, guys, if you want to add in any more questions for Rowan and I, just drop them in the Q&A or chat. Just while I'm speaking, we'll get to those very shortly before the end of the webinar. But we also have some accounting and tax services available now. You can even bundle these together. Historically, you have to be on the most premium package to get access to all, but now you really can chop and change. You get our Essentials plan there, for example, which is just our documents, but then also include, you know, our tax services with it as well. These are actually the most affordable and best value options as well if you're looking at a bundle to lump things together, because then they do actually provide a full A to Z service when using us.